Hello friends, I am Ashwin, welcome to my chess channel. In this video, I will show you a beautiful practical chess traps when black plays early pawn to d5 in Sicilian Najdorf in order to freeze game. This game was played between Conel Alexander vs Milev in 1954 in Amsterdam. Alexander with the white pieces started the game with pawn to e4, when pawn to c5 by Milev, and now knight f3, pawn to d6, pawn to d4, pawn capture on d4, knight capture on d4, knight f6 attacking e4, knight c3 defending it, and now pawn to a6, and we are in the territory of Sicilian Najdorf. And here white played the bishop d3, while the popular response is in this position is bishop g5, bishop e3, or even bishop e2. But anyways, we have this bishop d3 in this position, and black plays pawn to e5, knight to e2, and here main move for black is to play bishop to e7. But he saw that he can play pawn to d5 in order to free his game. What do you think, friends? Can you play pawn to d5 in this position? Pause the video here and try to calculate the same. In the game, black played pawn to d5, and after e capture d5, knight capture d5, he saw that even bishop b5 won't work, because after pawn captured on b5, knight capture on d5 and bishop to e6, white has to retreat his knight to c3, and then queen capture d1, knight capture d1, knight to c6, and of course black is having a ruined pawn structure. I mean, black pawn structure is not good, but black's bishop, two bishops can compensate the same. So after e capture d5, knight capture d5, but here white is already winning. Pause the video here and find the winning move for white, and it is super simple, believe me. In this position, white played bishop to c4, and all of a sudden black's knight has been attacked 3 times, and the only move is knight to f6 in order to save his queen. For example, if you play knight capture on c3, then comes bishop capture on f7. Of course, you can't take the bishop, otherwise queen capture queen is just winning for white. So after bishop capture f7, black king has to go to king to e7 and bishop to g5. Check wins the queen. As king will move, white will gain the queen with queen capture on d8, and this is completely winning for white. And therefore knight f6 is the only move in this position, because bishop g5 can be prevented. But here white just played bishop capture f7 check, and this is already a winning. Not just one pawn, because if you play say king to e7, which is the only move, if king capture f7, then queen capture queen is just winning. But what black realized, that after bishop capture f7 check, king to e7, white is a pawn plus, and now white can go with bishop to d5, knight c6, and say bishop to g5, pinning this, and king to e8, and this knight can go to g3, and after bishop e7, try to unpin this knight and threatening knight capture d5. White can just take the knight, and after bishop capture on f6, it is very much clear that due to this bishop on d5, it is really difficult for black to get his king into the safety, and therefore he choose better to resign on move number 10 after bishop capture on f7. So friends, what do you think about this game and this practical chess trap? I hope you like this video, and if you like this video, please subscribe this channel, press the like button for the video, and do comment here, and stop playing early d5 if you are a Sicilian Najdorf player. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.